हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आज का टॉपिक फूड तो नहीं है लेकिन हेल्थ से रिलेटेड है, नेचर। द मिनट वी हियर दिस वर्ड वी ऑल कम अप विद थिंग्स लाइक आई हैड बीन टू सच एंड सच प्लेस वेयर देयर इज लॉट ऑफ नेचुरल ब्यूटी, ऑल माय लास्ट वेकेशन वाज इन नेचर। बट व्हाट वी ऑल फेल टू सी इज दैट नेचर इज ऑल अराउंड अस। द विंड ब्लोइंग, द मून एंड द सन राइजिंग एंड सेटिंग, द बर्ड्स चर्पिंग, द ट्रीज अराउंड अस। और तो और हम तो ये भी अवेयर नहीं है कि हमारी खिड़की के बाहर जो पेड़ है उसके पत्ते कब झड़ गए और कब नए उग गए। सो एक्चुअली इट्स ऑल अबाउट नॉट विजिटिंग, नेचर इज नॉट अबाउट विजिटिंग अ प्लेस बट इट इज़ आर होम, इट इज़ आर नेचुरल हैबिटेट। और तो और आर किड्स आर टोटली डिस्कनेक्टेड विद नेचर, दे प्रेफर स्टेइंग इंडोर्स बिकॉज उनके गैजेट्स, उनके इलेक्ट्रिकल पॉइंट्स सब कुछ तो इंडोर है। So they prefer that and they are hooked up to this digital world. In today's time, a kid from the age of 8 to 18 years is spending 7.5 hours per day, 7 days a week with their gadgets like their laptops, their phones, their music system, their TVs, their video games and so on. In fact, they're so much better skilled handling these gadgets and playing these games than biking, cycling, swimming, hiking and so on. So they have kind of lost the connect, and this is called the nature deficit disorder, where there is no connection between nature and the person. So they have literally disconnected, they find no meaning between these things. They cannot find any kind of, you know, any kind of a connection with these things happening around them. And so what has happened that they have lost the fact that nature is actually has a positive effect on lifestyle, on health, on our happiness. And so they have become dull, they have become lethargic, there is obesity setting in and so on. Whereas nature has a lot of positive effect on things like asthma, ADHD and obesity. In fact, these kids get very less opportunity also because as parents, we are also scared to take them out to these places. We would prefer taking them to malls, to restaurants, to food courts, but not to open farms, grounds and parks because we are scared of diseases and germs. But we need to understand that a plant grows to its full potential in the soil. When it gets good soil, good water and good quality sunlight, then it is growing. It is growing well, it is nurturing. That is the way of nature. It follows its own cycle, but we humans do not. We are scared. But if we want, we need to understand that there is a strong connection between nature, health, happiness and intelligence. So if we want our kids to be healthier, happier, smarter and more creative, we need to bring back this connect with the nature. So, iske liye we don't have to go to far off places. We don't have to look beyond and visit places. We just have to look around us and find those little windows, those little opportunities to give it to our kids. It could be anything. It could be just going out in the park and giving them a 1 hour free time to play, taking them to the grounds for exercising, maybe just letting them feed the birds, giving them a time to ride their bikes, letting them spend time with plants if you're one of those lucky ones in your gardens or in your terrace, or maybe just with the pots and plants in their balcony. So this is how they would be, you know, getting more connected, and then they would understand what a blessing nature is for them. All that they have been reading in the books, that nature gives us this and the environment gives us that, that would really become practical for them. Once they experience that, they would learn to be grateful, and then they would be really wanting to take care of this nature, and that is when the future of environment would become sustainable. And if we're talking about immunity, let me tell you that immunity increases when we let our kids play in the dirt. So let them play in some dirt, let them walk bare feet, let them touch the things around them. And do you even know about the 6 second rule? If some food falls on the floor, you count till 6 and you can pick it up and feed it to your kids or eat it yourself. So we need to understand that it is not that everything around us is dirty. So let them run bare feet on the ground, let them enjoy the coolness of the mud, let them feel the warmth of the Mother Nature, Mother Earth, and let them feel the pricks of the grass blades. In fact, walking bare has become so rare at home also. Let them walk bare feet, let them connect to the ground. And this connection, this emotional connection which has been lost between human and nature, is actually leading to the environmental crisis. So we should take care and teach these kids that it is not important to sanitize ourselves and our homes, but it is important to sanitize our environment. It is important to clean this environment. So when they're connected, it is this future generation which is going to go ahead and do some plogging, and they are also going to make sure that there is, reduction in this discarding of plastics and the urination and the spitting, all that is going wrong. This future generation then would move ahead strongly and take care of their mother nature and their environment. So this is what we need to do. We need to take the advantage of the healing nature of nature and help nurture the environment and bring upon our kids a lot of health. And this is for you, Shovik sir, because this is what you taught us when we were running in grounds. So thanks a lot, and I do hope that all of us parents would understand this and let their kids enjoy the environment and mother nature. Thank you.